Hey, what's up? This is Greg Lorenzo, JIT, aka JIT Beats, producer, beat maker, record dealer. My childhood was great, you know. I came from a good family. My mom and dad were both from Brooklyn. They moved us out to Staten Island, New York, give us a better life. My dad was an electrician. My mom was a school teacher in Manhattan. I had a good childhood. JIT stands for, like, the original name for B-Boy. A graffiti character on the wall in, like, a B-Boy stance with the Pumas and the Adidas. They used to call them JITs back in the days. So that's a friend of mine gave me the name JIT. He nicknamed me JIT because he said I looked like a graffiti character. I would probably have to say Pink Floyd, The Wall, was my first introduction to really collecting vinyl. It was my first record. My grandmother bought it for me on 86th Street in Brooklyn. And I was just memorized by the artwork and just the music was just incredible. So from there, I started DJing, going to the record stores and collecting records and so on. 100,000 records later, here I am. I mean, with the art of digging, you gotta go places that most people don't go. You know, yard sales, thrift shops, just all around, you know, word of mouth. You know, I'm in the music business, so I know a lot of people, as well as I really get out there and I really dig. You know, it's always the luck of the draw, but, you know what you're doing, you know what the music you're looking for. And sometimes when you don't know what the music you're looking for, those are the best things to find, is the stuff you're not sure of what it is, but you read on the back, the instrumentation and the names of the song, and you know, you take a chance for a dollar, a quarter, 50 cents, two, three, five, whatever you spend, and you go home and that record is just amazing and it's like no one has it. That's a great thing. Some of my favorite albums, Beastie Boys, License to Ill, Tribe Called Quest, Midnight Marauder, and Low End Theory, Wu-Tang's first album, J Dilla Donuts, Nas's Illmatic, and, Prince, The Purple Rain, you know, something I could listen to without skipping. The vinyl market is a very tricky market. It's kind of like stocks, it's up and down. So, in other words, if you see a record out there and you only see it out there once every few years, there's a pretty high demand for that record if it's a great record. But once you see 10, 20 copies of it every year, the market intends to really drop on that record. And it's a lot easier to get and a lot more affordable for people to get it. The client base is all over the board, you know. I deal with people who want, you know, low-end records and people who want high-end records. People who want common records, people who want rare records. There's really no set genre that I deal with. Back in the days, I used to love, like, The Apartment, Nell, The Building, The Tunnel of Palladium. Nowadays, it would be more like Mobile Mondays, or Natasha Diggs does a party called Soul in the Home, which is kind of like a rare groove thing where she plays 70s, 80s, 90s, now music, and then there's a live band in between with my boy Osa Monday, DJs a few times a year in New York, so I go check him out. He spins like more like, you would say, a soulful house and stuff like that, for U of a Records, which I'm a part of the label. We'll be right back. produce hip-hop, trip-hop, dance, experimental music, a little bit of everything, whatever feels good. I worked with Yoruba Records, BBE Records, Payday, and a few other indie labels. My favorite drum machine would probably be the SP-1200, MPC-2000XL, the EPS-16-bit Plus, which I started with, which is definitely like a Staten Island thing. And then most recently, I picked up the MPC Touch, which I'm now learning. Well, I think the newer technology, it has its good ways and its bad ways. The bad ways to me is everything is very high-end. And it doesn't really have that analog punch, and it doesn't have that soul that the old drum machines have. I would always say it starts off with my drums, because the rhythm for me is everything, that's the spine. Then I layer the keys and the samples, or you know, whatever I add, the bass. And just keep a nice organic flow, you know, very spiritual vibe. And yeah, that's what makes me me. Anything from the next generation, I would hope that they would carry on the legacy of making great music and studying great artists that came before them, because I think that's very important in the creating process of making great music. The most important things in my life is definitely my family first, my health, making music, and just being happy. Do what you love to do. Life is short. Live life to the fullest. One day at a time. I won't fly, 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 fly.